looks like the most simple sukuri, but it's actually the hardest. Trying to cut a straight line all the way down.
Awesome.
finish, we have a tendency to bring our head in the direction of where our hips are. We should try to keep our body as natural as possible, our posture as natural as possible.
Try again.
Now we go into
пожалуйста.
И это причина, по которой мы готовим яйца, должен быть делать полное разрезание.
When it has to go faster, then you cook quicker.
Когда варенье успеет, то и, соответственно, так короче.
Thank you, Mr. So it feels best for me to have Five more times with
miss them. So, remember, training is big, big movements.
Помните, что тренировка – это большие движения.
We have to open up.
Мы должны раскрыться, выпустить энергию.
Open our movements up, get our energy out.
Открыть движение и выплеснуть
энергию. Next, doing Goro Suguri.
Сейчас мы будем делать Goro
Suguri. To
So the tension goes into the hands.
Напряжение уходит в руки.
It's like when you punch. You're not tense all the time.
Мышцы не напрягаются в плечах, когда ударяете.
Right at the point of impact, and you let go.
Прикладываете усилия, когда вы выполняете движение в конечном положении.
Just a slight tension right at the point of impact.
Небольшое напряжение в конечном пункте.
And it's the same with our hands and hey.
То же самое с руками в момент выполнения.
Just that one instant, and that's what gives shime.
Один момент, и это дает нам шиме.
Shime is the slight movement, the little. So be careful of too much tension all the time.
Будьте внимательны, чтобы не напрягаться все время.
It's not good for our body.
Это не очень хорошо для тела.
Again, it's unnecessary.
И это вообще не нужно.
So next, Gokuro Sui.
Следующий урок.
Sideways.
Это положение, когда
Each of the suguri has something we can learn. I've been making some points that I feel are important. And it's important that every person, every time you do suguri, think about what am I learning from this. Make each suguri your first and last. If you say to yourself, I'm going to do 500 first suguri, spending more time counting, was this number 157 or 158? And you'll lose the whole, in my opinion, the whole purpose of suguri. It's called mushin. Mushin means no thought. You have to close your thinking process. Just become a, you would call it a vessel, an instrument for doing the suguri. So, it's great to do a lot of suguri, but you have to make each one have meaning. We have a lot of people here, so we're going to try to do a little awasana.
Поэтому мы пытаемся...
from where my hand is.
Я ударяю не
Sensei, when I was learning, it was, say, a little bit past the rib cage, the right hand.
Later on, it became more direct.
basically just see through this position. But to keep things safe, then I would signal saying, now I'm ready for you to attack. Hey! Well, what happens is people start doing this. Then they have to reach way over to get the drone. And hips move the wrong way. So it's good to signal that I'm ready, but it also, it becomes exaggerated, and that makes it hard to do. I like the idea that I have to know when he's going to attack.
Massage
people. They're called amma.
What is amma?
there were bad guys that would come and attack him from behind. So Osensei thought about what he could do because they walked using a stick. And he said that Osensei developed a technique where he would go,
ah!
He said it was very, very lethal technique. The way I understood it was he greatly injured the person who he was defending himself against. So when we do this movement here, Saito Sensei made the point of, when I was learning, that the jaw goes under the arm. When it goes under the arm here, you have it at an angle. And the basic form, continue the line that the angle starts. If we want to do it for chunan, then it separates from under the arm, and it becomes unstable. If we want to apply the technique, we can go in any level. But to create a stable basic form, under the forearm, and then keep the same angle. We want to get something that is standing on the center line. In the old days, we would step off the side and in. Now just on the line. Again, we have to rotate the hips counter. The head turns just enough so I can see out of the corner of my eye. And I'm staying in Hanmi. If I turn this way, then it doesn't become Ushirotsuki. Let's try. Next one. Watching Saito Sensei, I can see he's back here. And again, sort of like watch time. You're hiding the joke. David Alexander, the senpai I was talking about, he said in the old days, you didn't rotate the jaw in an arc. Went straight in from the side. It's a very effective move. We're going against the knee. So we'll do serious damage. Later on,
позже добавилось боковое движение.
It's also a very strong dynamic.
Это тоже очень сильное и динамичное движение.
Let's try the old form first.
Давайте сначала потренируем старую форму. Все более и более он использовал много подобных
акцентов. For a period, when he was teaching, he would say, "Don't copy my leg movements because my knees hurt."
И позже он говорил, что не копируйте.
But after a while, he stopped saying that. I remember in Iwama when we practiced, he would draw lines in the sand. And so he would show which angles he would take and which side of the
line of attack would move off to.
И показывал, по каким углом надо двигаться по отношению к цепочке, какой углом уходить с линии атаки.
45 degree angles for Gedan Gaishin.
Gedan Gaishin, это 45 градусов.
It's heavy! Neat. Sound. Yadi.
Он спутал Yadi.
Yadi is a spear.
Yadi – это рапира.
And Naginata.
Naginata.
And Ken.
И Ken.
And what else did he say? I think he said Juken, a bayonet. And Joe. He said it was all a mix. But he said Tai Sabaki is from Aikido. So there's no clear history of the Joe. It's O-sensei's invention. He said he studied all these things, he studied them by watching. And combined all his influences. Very special, the Aikido. So, we've done Ski Hinangaishi, and let's finish with Ski Jodangaishi. So, this includes three most important ways of using the joke.
Эта техника включает три важных способа использования joke.
Ski.
Ski.
And this, Hinangaishi.
Hinangaishi.
And Shomenushi.
И Shomenushi.
So, here. Since the joke is coming over our head, it can go in a slight angle around for yokomen. Or it can go down. To me, it feels most natural to let the joe go a little bit around. So let's try. What happens is that people come here and then they start to far back.
Не слишком далеко.
Face on.
Иначе это открывает ваше лицо.
So when you turn here,
чтобы когда вы повернули,
you can make a nice big
strike. Хороший, большой удар.
Hey. Hi, guys. Sorry, maybe this class was boring. We were just doing basic techniques.
Иногда я применяю метод перед тем, как получать пятую строй.
Because that way the hands, you already understand how to use the hands.
Потому что здесь вы понимаете, в какой лектуре идут ваши руки.
Then you can add the step.
А потом вы просто добавляете шаг.
So now I'd like us to try it. Like I was talking about yesterday, when we were doing each no sukuri.
Сейчас мы будем пытаться, как мы делали в прошлый раз, когда делали первый сукуре.
That it's one movement.
Что это одно движение.
Let's try the same thing here.
Давайте то же самое попытаемся сделать здесь.
When we start, we make one cut, shomotoshi, that's each no sukuri.
Когда мы начинаем, мы делаем одно движение, один разрез, это each no sukuri.
When we turn, we should also try to make it in one movement. Instead of one. Once we start turning, we can do it slowly. When we start to move the sword, we should make it in one cut. Instead of. So let's try that. Hitting the head. Men in his face, the showman is also the face. But for instance, in kendo, when you do shomenuchi, you strike the head and you stop. We strike the head and cut all the way through. To stabilize the hips. Like Saito-sensei said, keiko wa oki. Keiko is always big movements. And if you really want to cut through something or hit through something with a bokken or a sword, you have to really put your hips into it. We'll do the same movement, but now moving forward. Hey, it's. Hey, knee. H. Knee. So, slide stepping forward. These are the first movements we're doing, so don't put too much power into it. We have to warm up. Put spirit into it, but don't put power into it. Right, this one. You can't push back on the front foot this way. I have to turn.
Я должен развернуться и дальше.
I see some people are turning on their heels.
Я видел, как некоторые сворачивались на носочках.
And some are turning on the balls of the foot.
И некоторые поворачивались на основании большого пальца ноги.
I recommend turning on the balls of your foot.
Я рекомендую, чтобы вы сворачивались на обеих ступнях.
Because when we push off with our feet, that's the part we use.
Если мы нажимаем на
as much as possible. So, basically when we're stepping, we're trying to use the balls of our feet. It gives us a softer and more, a better connection to the floor. You can try it when you're walking on wood. You get the difference? That's the heel. And that's the ball of the foot. So we should try to move as lightly as possible. Also, if you're walking on the heels of your feet, it'll go into your back. So let's try the same thing and focus on how we turn.
То же самое, мы должны сконцентрироваться на моменте поворота.
thrusting somebody in the crowd.
Если кто-то будет как бы из своей территории, он будет может увидеть другого, мы находимся в толпе.
So let's be sure that we get everybody moving together.
Поэтому давайте двигаться вот в этом ритме едином, чтобы делать все вместе.
So remember, after each strike, we're always striking on the right foot.
После каждого удара, который мы наносим на нашу правую ногу,
and we take one step to ski on the left foot.
И делаем каждый раз ски с левой ноги на левую ногу.
Hey, nice. So we cut diagonals. There are different ways of doing this. I like the old way.
It
has a big turn, I think it's 7/8 turn. Let's do it slowly. We know shihoki, so we just have to add two movements. I want to cut over there.
Я хочу разрезать здесь.
So I have to set up the back of my hand.
Я должен расположить заднюю часть моей ноги. В том направлении.
Then I have the other angles to cut. That's not so hard. It's a smaller turn.
Остальные углы не такие большие, поэтому легче делать.
So think about that corner. That's the one we want to cut for the first angle.
Думайте о том угле. Это первый угол по диагонали, который мы должны
разрезать.
Добавляем ски в
разные
На всем протяжении.
Just like when we start the class. It tunes our spirits into each other. And the same when we do movements together, ki-ai together. It brings us together. So it's both movements and ki-ai. It's also a feeling of kimusubi. Tying our feet together. Same thing. H. A. D. Now, stepping into the ski with the left foot. And this is going to bring us out of our first starting
point.
So it's going to take more space. So let's be careful, do it slowly so everybody can move together.
Он обойдет
по мечу.
Но я улучшаю свой
Pukeru means to receive.
Pukeru means получение.
And that means that I haven't finished this movement.
Это означает, что я не закончил это движение.
He can still attack. I move away. But I have my sword high there.
Я ушел, но мой меч еще высоко.
If I were to do what's called Kimeruken, then I would cut his center line, but I would stay where I am. That means I would actually be cutting him. So, Kimeruken, I'll do this time. I don't slide back. And I cut straight down his center line. So, my block is also a cut. Because I'm always connecting my center line and my sword to his center line. So, lifts up, center line, and I slide back. Stop here. And I should have my sword in the center line. And by keeping my hips engaged, his sword is off of my center line. And last one, number three, I cut deep. Kimura means to finish. Or to decide. So we'll do three carries. So he's attacking forward once. Knee. We need to have our swords flexible in this direction.
Нам нужно, чтобы наш меч гибко, какой-то гибко удерживался в этом направлении.
If there's any pressure this way.
Если давление оказывается в этом направлении, по кого?
If he's fighting to try to get my center line, then he's giving me energy to return the attack. So there should be a flexible feeling in the swords this way. No pushing against the swords. Kimeruken. So, I'm what's called Uketachi. That means the person receiving the attack. Vicha is Uchitachi. Attacking person. Uketachi is moving more or less back on the line. And Uchitachi has to come to the side to attack. And he needs to come close here. This is the actual distance that we need. So he wants to cut with this part of the sword. So see, my front foot, I just turn a little bit, my back foot, a little bit to this side, and that creates the angle. Goes off to this side. Just a slight angle from Uketachi. Thank you.
sword up to parry.
Когда я понимаю свой меч для того, чтобы брать себя атаку.
It's the same as the first Suguri, it's just going backwards. But it's not a cut. It's a parry. So that means So if I'm going back like a cut, I'm too open. So my sword only goes. So I have the feeling of my blade is protecting me. Saito Sensei never put this in words. But when you watched him very carefully, you could see that his hips and his sword, when he was lifting up, were moving together. So it wasn't up, then the person moved over there, down. There was a very subtle movement of the hips. This way. So as soon as he starts moving over there, so like I showed you, no matter what, even if my hips and honey aren't there, or even if my honey is there, my hips aren't
there.
So if I'm going too far back, I lose that feeling. So, up. Goes to the side. Up. And final, middle kick. So, I'm only lifting up to about here. Of course, it depends on the size of the person who is attacking you. I have to close the talk. Just a minute, I want to show you something. Everybody's taller than me, right? So in this case, I have to go up here. My hands are a little bit higher. Basically, I have to keep my this part of the sword between me and where the sword is coming from. If it goes away from where the sword is, I'm open. And remember one more thing. This is, we can always train Suguri when doing this. All the things we have to remember about Suguri, Gono Suguri, Fifth Suguri. See if you're doing this. That's the number one problem. Myself included. Always have to be careful about that. If you don't have your weight distributed correctly, if you have too much weight forward, then you move the foot forward. We can still be working on polishing our own form. And working on correcting things, making our form better. But that has to go down to a second priority level. The most important is kimusubi with our partner. Because if I'm about to, I'm being attacked, And then I started thinking, oh, I have to correct my hips here and my hands here. I lose the connection to my partner. And that's dangerous. It's also egoistic. Because you lose the connection and your partner's going, where are you? You're sort of disappearing into yourself. We do that when we're doing supuri. Because it doesn't affect anybody else. So please be careful of that. First priority is to keep connection with your partner all the time. We start in Kamae and step two. First is the same as Bunavasana, just to the opposite side. Ukeruken. Right? Now I have this movement. Sometimes this was called Maki Otoshi. Maki means to wrap. Otoshi means to drop. My intention is to do this, this, anything like that. Sweep this aside, so I have center. But when I do that, it creates an opening. And when that happens, I step back. And this is the same as when we are parrying against the strike, but it's ski. So my blade is at a 45 degree angle, and his is too. Not like that. So three elements. Usually you do it, the three elements, two or three times. But we don't have room, so we'll just go. Change. Use your hips. Wait a little bit after Maki Otoshi. Movements. All
demand was.
Тогда мы ощущаем вот взаимосвязь всех элементов и тот гений, который присущ.
It's one system that all fits together.
Очень хорошо друг друга входит в такой
состояние. Absolute miracle.
Абсолютное чудо то, что он
every cable, when we start and finish, we value the thing of what this man has made for us.
Каждая, когда тренировка заканчивается, мы кланяемся, мы должны все время помнить о том, что такое был наш сенсей, что он
сотворил. Let's finish with 10 first suburis facing forward with full kiai.
Давайте закончим с 10 субури с полным киаем, с лицом к шуму.
If you want to progress in your Aikido, use the mirror. Watch yourself and try to remember the things that we've been talking about here. If you look at what you're doing, you'll be able to catch many of the things that we've been working on.
Hey!
we have two cuts that we usually don't do in Suguri.
Guys, This doesn't fit.
Это не подойдет.
Oh, here.
Вот так.
But my next movement.
My следующее движение.
I keep this foot here. I don't have time. Attack is one.
Они атакуют вдвоем, пока один.
Come on.
Освогайся слови.
Медленно отрасывай.
Turn and show it.
Поворот и уже лучше.
That way it does have The same as in Zengogiri. Remember the way we tried to turn. And remember, you're not supposed to have your hands sitting below your heart. Bad form. So, we're turning on the ball to our foot. That sets the hip. Make sure that the foot is properly placed, the rear foot. Saito sensei used to always say, Kyujudo, 90 degrees.
Saito sensei всегда повторял, Kyujudo, то есть 90 градусов.
Here's the camera. But if he washed his foot, he would always have it a little bit pointing this way.
Если смотреть на его ногу, то мы могли увидеть, что его нога чуть-чуть наклонена.
Should you do what your sensei says or what he does?
Опять же вопрос. Что делать? То, что мы видим, то, что мы слышим.
Being a good deshi, you have to choose.
Будучи хорошим деши, вы должны выбирать.
So in that case, I'm choosing to do what I saw him do.
Я выбираю то, что я видел.
Because when we want to push off, when we want to move forward,
потому что когда мы хотим уже двигаться вперед,
we're using foot that way.
Мы таким образом используем ногу.
If the foot is sideways, it becomes
если нога развернута в сторону,
a strange movement where you sort of have to push off from the edge of the foot, the inside edge.
Становится таким странным движением, когда мы отталкиваемся внутренним ребром стопы.
Turn the foot a little bit, with the heel a little bit back. The push comes from here.
И когда мы развернем чуть-чуть, то как раз давление, отталкивающее ногу, приходится на переднюю часть стопы.
There are small details, but they're important if we want to learn how to move nicely.
Вроде бы маленькая деталь, но она нам очень поможет, если мы хотим хорошо двигаться.
So, we set. When turning, we set the back of our hind knee.
Когда мы поворачиваемся, мы помещаем, как бы устраиваем заднюю часть нашей камни.
Make sure the back foot doesn't point backwards.
И следите за тем, чтобы задняя нога не поворачивалась назад.
And eight. Hang on, it's smart.
То же самое, как мы делали в паблике.
So, slowly.
Медленно.
We have to sweep right from where it is. Step in.
And then. Шаги.
Step, step.
Дальше два шага. Один нога на диске.
If it's on horizontal level.
Очень трудно отразить джо, когда оно находится в горизонтальном положении.
We have to create an angle with the джо.
Мы должны джо создать угол.
So I'm lowering my hip, my back hip. Even though I'm smaller than Jenna, I still have to go down to create an angle. So my idea is, I don't have to parry his jaw that hard. It's only so that his jaw goes away from my center. My jaw just to the edge of where his body is. And back again. Trains our hands well.
более большое движение и хорошо тренирует наши руки.
So let's try to do that as a partner practice.
Давайте сделаем это в качестве парной практики.
Boss. So in this case, let me see. I can give him Jochen's ski.
В этом случае я.
He comes in here. Yeah. Now this will be my block.
Это будет мой блок.
Then I will go in. Later on we'll work on Hayagaishi, where? We go straight into the strike. We'll go into the parry here. And then from here, right into the middle of the dome. So this is ski, then Jodan Gaishi. Remember yesterday I was saying that David Alexander showed the old form?
Помните, вчера я вам рассказывал, что Дэвид Александр рассказывал про старую форму?
Of ski Jodan Gaishi. And he said that this was the more refined form. So this is like what we're doing in number 13,
14, 15
in the Kumijo. But it gives us a good practice for learning to move the hands and start. So now my partner is parrying. Jodan Gaishi. We can parry straight away.
Okay.
Go slow. So after the parry, wait 2 or 3 seconds.
Начинайте медленно. После того, как вы отразили удар, вы ждите 1-2 секунды.
So that's one thing we have to be careful about. It's very easy because we're used to centering our hand. This feels natural to us. But we have to think about what we're covering. So here. So in this case, it's sort of like with Gidan Gaishi. Our hands are in connection with this part, with our shoulders. Sort of the same. The hand's different here. I'm holding this way for Gidan Gaishi. But the basic position. But in this case now, it's with the front, the thumb forward. But it's still the same.
So
be careful. Don't be too far over with it.
Будьте внимательны, не задвигайте руку далеко в голове.
Another thing is the angle. So, just ski. If my angle is not wide enough, it's hard to really sort of control the jaw, his jaw. If it's too wide, it slips through.
Вот,
Right about here.
Где-то здесь.
And I'm not trying to blast his jaw up.
И не пытаюсь я подкинуть его джо вверх.
It's just a little bit of control.
Это просто легкий контроль.
And then I move into.
Дальше я передвигаюсь.
Джорангайши.
Джорангайши.
A little bit more. Now I'm skiing.
Еще кое-что. Сейчас я делаю ски.
Another thing to be careful of.
Еще одна вещь, которую вы должны быть очень внимательно. Опять.
Be careful of over-exaggerating the movement.
Не старайтесь чрезмерные движения делать.
Dropping the jaw to
Сначала,
move it upwards.
Вниз опускаем jaw, потом вверх поднимаем оттуда.
It feels very dynamic.
Конечно, это кажется очень динамично, да.
But you're moving the jaw away from where it's supposed to be going.
Но на самом деле вы уводите джо от того, куда оно должно двигаться.
I did this a lot myself.
Я сам много раз это делал.
So, his jaw's coming in just around and under.
Джо сразу идет вокруг и вверх.
With these details in mind.
Вот сохраняя в голове эти детали, еще раз, следить за тем, чтобы ваша передняя рука не выскакивала вперед, не сдвигалась вперед и слишком сильно.
The forward arm, it's in between, fully stretched.
Это что-то между полного растяжения руки
and bent.
И вот этого движения подтягивающего.
We need to have room here to use the jaw.
Иметь пространство впереди для того, чтобы использовать джо.
But be careful it doesn't move in too much. It's a this is a big difference from here.
Существует большая разница отсюда сюда. Из этого положения в это.
Here it's sort of like this movement. That's the way we use our arm, basically.
Здесь движение такое, как мы обычно используем руку.
Here.
Здесь.
If we're doing this in Taijutsu, we'd be corrected.
Если бы мы делали это в Taijutsu, нас бы поправили.
So, we have to be careful of that, the front arm. So now, I'd like to do Hayagaishi. Which means ski and straight in. We don't worry about the block. Saito-sensei did two variations of Hayagaishi. The way I learned it was a big circular movement.
То, как я учился, это было большое круговое движение.
Later on it became
позже
more
это стало как.
You see the difference? Big circle or the jaw goes up and around that way.
Разницу улавливаете, когда джо идет по большому кругу или просто вверх и вокруг вниз.
So it doesn't make the big circle.
Не делает большого круга.
Of course it's faster.
Конечно, это быстрее.
But should you do what your sensei says or what he does?
Но опять же встает вопрос о том, что же делать, то, что вы видите, или то, что слышите.
And in my case, I like to do what I learned back in the beginning.
Я бы в моем случае предпочел заменить делать то, что я научился чему в самом начале.
And I listen to him saying, Keiko Aokiku. Training is big movements. So, let's try to do the big movement. But look carefully and see what the instructor is doing wherever you are and try to copy exactly what that person is doing. You should never do what you learned in the last class if somebody is doing something different. It's very important. Each person has a way of doing things and a reason for doing them. And then finally when you go back, you do it the way your sensei is doing it. Don't say, oh, Ethan did it that way.
не говорите, о, он делает не так.
You say that, I'll be very sad.
Если так скажете, Итан очень горчится.
You have to make, you have to, like Saito Sensei was saying, you have to make your sensei want to teach you.
Как Saito Sensei говорил, вы должны заставить вашего учителя захотеть учить вас.
You can gather inspiration from other people, but you have to do what your sensei is doing.
Вы должны набираться вдохновения от других людей, но все-таки делать то, чему учит вас ваш сенсей.
Or start your own dojo.
Или начинать свой собственный dojo.
So, here. Big movement. There you go. So, light ski. Now he's...